Welcome back to Dr. Drvenkys in Physiology. Today we are going to continue with where we left off in the previous class, right? In the previous class we dealt with countercurrent multiplication, right? In this class we are going to deal with countercurrent exchange mechanism, right? Now the countercurrent multiplication, it helped in creating hyperosmolar renal medullary interstitium, right? Now once this is created, this has to be maintained. If it is not maintained, then a concentrated urine cannot be formed by the kidney, right? This hyperosmolarity is maintained by two factors. One is low medullary blood flow, right? Another one is countercurrent exchange mechanism. Okay, these two factors, they help in maintaining the hyperosmolarity in renal medullary interstitium, right? The blood flow to the medulla is less than 5% of total renal blood flow. Okay, so this less amount of blood flow to the medulla is sufficient to cover the metabolic needs of the medullary tissues, and it prevents the washout of solutes, from medulla. Okay, so this is factor one. Okay, and factor two, the countercurrent exchange. Okay, countercurrent exchange, this helps in trapping the solutes within the medullary interstitium. Okay, by this process it maintains the hyperosmolarity created by countercurrent multiplication, right? The countercurrent exchange is carried out by the peritubular capillaries of juxtamedullary nephrons called as vasa recta. Okay, now these capillaries, they follow the course of the juxtamedullary nephrons, starting from the Bowman's capsule through the course of the juxtamedullary nephron, right? So it has a, the vasa recta has a U-shaped limb. Okay, imagine this is the loop of Henle. Okay, the vasa recta, it follows the loop of Henle. Okay, this is vasa recta, this is loop of Henle. Okay, so this U shape is very, very important. Okay, in countercurrent exchange, let's see why. Two features of the vasa recta are essential to carry out countercurrent exchange. One is the U shape of vasa recta. Okay, and another one, similar to all the capillaries in the body, the vasa recta is permeable to water and solutes, okay, but impermeable to plasma proteins. Okay, so these two features of vasa recta help the vasa recta in carrying out the function of a countercurrent exchange. Let us see how the mechanism of countercurrent exchange takes place. Okay, in the vasa recta, we know that there is the descending limb, okay, and this one is the ascending limb, okay, right? Now what happens in the descending limb is, as the blood flows through the vasa recta towards the inner parts of medulla, this is medulla, this is cortex region, right? So as it flows through the vasa recta in this U limb, okay, in the descending limb, okay, what happens? This is renal medullary interstitium, right? This is renal medullary interstitium, right? in the descending limb, solutes from the renal medullary interstitium enter into the vascular compartment of the vasa recta. Okay. Meanwhile, water from the vasa recta leaves and enters the renal medullary interstitium. Okay. This is what happens in all the levels of descending limb. Solutes enter the vasa recta, water leaves the vasa recta and enters the renal medullary interstitium. Okay. While what happens in the ascending limb is opposite. Here, water enters from the renal medullary interstitium, okay, into the vascular compartment of the vasa recta. The solutes which already entered in the descending limb, now they leave the ascending limb and once again enters the renal medullary interstitium. So at all levels, now water enters back, solutes go back, leaves the vascular compartment and goes back into the renal medullary interstitium. Okay. So this is the mechanism by which countercurrent exchange takes place. So now what happens? Whatever solutes which was earlier in the renal medullary interstitium, finally it came back into the renal medullary interstitium. Okay. So the solutes circulated within the renal medullary interstitium, in other words, they are trapped within the renal medullary interstitium. They are not carried away into the systemic circulation. Okay. So by this mechanism, the countercurrent exchange is capable of maintaining the hyperosmolarity in the renal medullary interstitium. Right? Okay.